हरिओम। या देवी सित पंकजा सनवरा सीनाक्षमालाकरा वीणा झंकृति नष्ट सर्व जड़ता स्मेर प्रफुल्लानना या वाक्यार्थ पद प्रमाण विभवा या सर्वभाषात्मिका ताम वाचामधि देवतां भगवतीं वंदे सदा भारतीं। वेलकम यू ऑल ऑनलाइन एंड ऑफलाइन टू येट अनदर सेशन ऑफ मालविकाग्निमित्रम, the very first drama of Kavi Kulaguru Kalidasa. So in the last lecture we saw that Parivrajika is making the queen aware of her Radni Pada, and if Haradatta is patronized, there is a fight between two dance masters. It is a verbal fight so far, and now they want to prove their superiority, mutual superiority. And queen is little bit apprehensive, you know, because her person is Ganadasa, whom she has entrusted the newly acquired maid Malavika to be trained in dance and all, whereas Haradatta is appointed by the king and he has been teaching the younger queen Iravati for many more days or months, you know. So she is little bit apprehensive. And she says, oh no, yadyapi evam tathapi rajaparigraha asya pradhanatvam upaharati. For Haradatta, rajaparigraha, he has been patronized by the king. And then the Parivrajika says, Gautami, atimatra bhasuratvam pushyati bhanoho parigraha danalaha. If the fire gets its luster from the sun, so the fire is Haradatta, Analaha, and the sun is King Agnimitra, even so the chandra nisha parigrihitaha chandraha api mahimanam adhigacchati. The chandra, that is Ganadasa, who is favored by Nisha, that is Queen Dharini, is also gaining more importance. Do you notice here Haradatta is said to be Anala and Ganadasa is said to be Chandra, right? So in this, I was telling you last time how you can read between the lines, you know. Kalidasa never tells us about what is the age of Ganadasa and Haradatta, but we assume, we presume that Ganadasa might be an elderly person. He is as Sheetala, as compassionate perhaps as the moon, whereas Haradatta, like the Queen Iravati, whom he is training, right? She is also very bubbling and chulbula type of person, very chulbuli and very, you know, like outspoken and all that. Haradatta might be of that category. Kalidasa always has, you know, this passion of bringing out the contradictions between two characters, the pairs, always. So this, I feel, you know, having Ganadasa referred to as Chandra, Nisha Parigrihitaha Chandraha Api Mahimanam Adhigacchati, that also indicates at his Sheetalatva and perhaps his maturity, his seniority over Haradatta, right? And Vidushaka says now that both of them are coming. अविधा अविधा उपस्थिता पीठमर्दिकां पंडित कौशिकीं पुरस्कृत्य देवी धारिणी. हियर कम्स द क्वीन धारिणी पुटिंग इन फ्रंट पंडिता कौशिकी, हू इज हर क्लोज कंपेनियन. पीठमर्दिका, पीठ इज बैक, मर्दिका वन हू यू नो प्रेसिस युअर बैक, वन हू मसाजिस युअर बैक, always accompanying you at the back, follows you, you know. Normally, Pithamarada, according to Bharata's Natya Shastra, Pithamarada, Vita, Cheta, Vidushaka, these are some 3-4 characters who help the king in getting whatever he desires for. Especially the Vidushaka, Vita, Cheta, etc., these are the people who help him in his love affairs, the king, okay? But Pitamarda is more of an intellectual type, a companion, a close follower, always accompanying the king. So here Pitamardika, because the queen is always accompanied by Pandita Kaushiki, okay? She is Pandita Kaushiki, she is Pandita, she is intellectual, and perhaps she is a Buddhist monk. Perhaps she, we don't get clearly, you know, the ideas, but perhaps she is a Buddhist monk. And I referred to that historicity of the Shunga dynasty when we started with Malavika Agnimitram, that Pushyamitra who established the Shunga dynasty after the last Maurya king Brihadratha, he captured him, captivated him and took over the reins, you know. And he was a staunch Hindu, pakka Hindu, pakka Hindu. Whereas perhaps Agnimitra is more liberal in his approach, right? And therefore, if Pushyamitra is ruling from Magadha, from Pataliputra, Agnimitra's kingdom is, his capital is based in Vidisha, in the Malwa region of Madhya Pradesh. So any of these drama, the Sanskrit text, we cannot separate the history and geography from that, okay? And that is perhaps the reason why Agnimitra and Pushyamitra are not staying together, the son and the father duo. But when Pushyamitra has performed Ashwamedha sacrifice, Agnimitra sends his son Vasumitra to protect the sacrificial horse, Ashwamedhiya Ashwa, okay? So there is something between the father and the son, but yet the father Pushyamitra has performed a sacrifice and the Ashwa is let loose and Vasumitra is under the protection. So now this Pitamardika is the close companion, and normally, you know, Pitamarda or Pitamardika, they belong to a Brahmana jati, Brahmana varna. And you know, there is a likhita custom. Custom, what it is, that Kshatriya, the king, though he is an overruler of everything, it is always when they are going in front, it is the Purohita who is placed in the front. The very name Purohita, Puraha, Hitaha, Hitaha, Dha, Dha is to place. One who is placed in the front, Puraha, in the front, Hitaha, is called Purohita. So a Brahmana is placed in the front and then follows the Kshatriya. Okay. Agrataha Chaturo Vedan Prushthataha Sasharam Dhanuhu. That was Parashurama boasting of. He can boast of the Chatura Veda, all the Vedas, as well as his martial power. Okay. So Purohita, Pitamardika being a Brahmana category, and Brahmana is not just a Jati Brahmana. Brahma Janati iti Brahmanaha, one who knows Brahma, one who knows Veda, one who is knowledgeable is Brahmana. Pitamarda, Pitamardika belong to that category, and therefore they lead the show, and the queen or the king, the Kshatriya Varna, they just follow. And therefore Pitamardikam Pandita Kaushikim Puraskritya Devi Dharini Pravishati. And avidha, avidha, you know, this is an exclamation. People translate it differently. It could be, you know, maybe it's a warning, hidden warning given to King Agnimitra. Now beware, Dharini is coming. You be, you know, in your senses and don't make, you know, extra efforts to show your eagerness or curiosity in this fight. You are playing a neutral role. This is all devised by me. The fight between the two dance masters is the whole and soul credit goes to Vidushaka. So Agnimitra should be in his senses, should not make too much, you know, extravagant efforts to be curious, oh, when can I see Malavika? He has to be calm. So that's a warning perhaps, avidha, avidha. Look, look, here comes the queen, okay? Control yourself. So Pashyami Enam, Raja describes the queen. Mangala Lankrita Bhati Kaushikya Yativeshaya Trayi Vigraha Vatyeva Samamadhyatma Vidyaya. He praises Queen Dharini. Dharini, we have seen Dharini, Iravati, two queens. Iravati is a younger queen, perhaps more beautiful, but little immature. And Dharini is an older queen. She is a Mahishi and she has a son old enough, Vasumitra, 16 years of age, who can go to protect the horse of Ashwamedha. So she is entering Kaushikya Yativeshaya with Kaushiki, who is attired in Yativesha, in the Sannyasavesha. Yativesha, Kashayavastra, Sannyasavesha. So Yativeshaya Kaushikya Iyam Bhati Ayanti Dharini Bhati Kathamiva Trayi Vigrahavatyeva. She looks as if Vigrahavati Trayi. Trayi is the three Vedas, the Rig Veda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, collectively called as Trayi. Atharva Veda is excluded from this. Otherwise, we have Chatvaraha Vedaha. But whenever there is a reference to Trayi, it is devoid of Atharva Veda. Okay. So, Trayi Vigrahavati Eva, as if she is the personification of the three Vedas collectively together. Who? Queen Dharini. And she is entering. And how is she? Mangalalankrita. As a queen, she is decked all over. And for a woman, to be decked is the Mangala Alankarana. A Vivahita Stri has to wear, you know, the tatanka and the bindi and the mala and what not. These are the Saubhagya Lakshana. And therefore, this queen is entering here adorned with all the auspicious jewellery which she is supposed to wear. So, Mangala Alankrita, Ayanti Iyam Devi Dharini Katham Iva Bhati Vigrahavati Trayi Iva Bhati. But she is accompanied by Kaushiki. So, for Kaushiki also there is a simile, Samam Adhyatma Vidyaya. As if Adhyatma Vidya has taken the bodily form of Kaushiki and the three Vedas have taken the bodily form of Queen Dharini. So here comes the Trayi along with the Adhyatma Vidya because Pandita Kaushiki is attired in a Sannyasavesha, Yativeshaya. And therefore Yativesha goes with Adhyatma Vidya and Mangalalankrita Dharini goes with Trayi Vigrahavati. Okay, so this is a fantastic upama and this shows the king's respect towards the queen. Whenever the king and the queen have to greet each other, there are some protocol, there are some like formalities they have to follow. Okay, so when the queen comes again, she will also do her formalities in front of all the people. In private, she can accuse him, but in public, she has to follow certain protocol. So because he is a king, he is an enthroned king, right? So Parivrajika comes, Upetya Vijayatam Devaha. She salutes the king. Let the king be victorious. Bhagavati Abhivadaye. He will bow down, you know, because it's a Brahmana, it's a Yativesha, it is Adhyatma Vidya. So a person has to show respect. Bhagavati Abhivadaye. And after getting the salutations, the elderly people always bless you, okay? So the blessing comes from Parivrajika. This is the protocol. This is the protocol. Whether you are young or older by age, you have to bow down to a sannyasi, you have to bow down to a guru, however young the guru may be, because we know, Chitram Vatataror Mule, Vriddha Shishya Guru Yuva, Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam Shishya Chinna Samshayaha. It may be sometimes, you know, the Guru is young and the Shishya are Vriddha, but he is a Guru, you have to bow down to him and the Guru has to bless. So here the Parivrajika blesses him. Mahas, very beautiful verse. Mahasara Prasavayoho Sadrisha Kshamayoho Dvayoho Dharini Bhuta Dharinyoho Bhava Bharta Sharachatam. Bhava Bharta Sharachatam. You be the Bharta. Bharta, Bharana Poshana Karta, the nourisher, the upbringer, the protector. Bharta, Bhru Bharanat. Okay? Bharta normally means husband. But why he is called Bharta? because he takes care of the wife. Okay? And therefore, wife is called Bharya, one who is fit to be nourished, taken care of by her husband. Bharya Jaya, Jayate Asyam Putra Rupena Patihi, iti Jaya. Now, etymological meaning gives you exactly the sense in which the Sanskrit language has developed and coined so many words for wife. There is only W-I-F-E, one word wife. Okay? Wedded wife or what? But then there are so many hundreds of names in Sanskrit, each giving you a separate tinge of meaning. Some nuances are there, some details are there. So, Jaya is Asyam Jayate iti. So, if the woman has not given birth, she can't be called Jaya in the strictest sense of the term. She can be called Patni, she can be called Bharya, but not a Jaya. Right? So, these are the some details of that. So, Bharta Sharat Shatam Bhava. You be the Bharta, you be the husband of Dharini and Bhava Dharini, that is the earth. Normally, the king is supposed to be the Bharta of the earth as well. You know, if you remember the Varaha Avatara, Bhudevi is regarded as the wife of Vishnu in his Varaha incarnation because he uplifted the Bhudevi on his task in the Varaha Rupa. So, normally he is called Bhupati, the king is called Bhupati, Bhuvaha Patihi, Bhumi Patihi, Nrupatihi because he is the Pati, the protector of the people, but he is the protector and the Pati, husband of the earth, therefore he is called Bhupala, Bhupa, Bhupati, right? So you be the Bharata for Shatam Sharad, for 100 years. Sharad is the Sharad season, basically. Sharad is the Sharad season. That is what? Autumn. Sharad is autumn. Now, why, you know, this is again an interesting thing. Maybe I'll give this for your homework, okay? Why a year is called as Shatam, Sharad. Jivet Sharadashatam, Pashyema Sharadashatam, Shrunuyama Sharadashatam. All these are Vedic chantings. Let us live for 100 years. Let us see for 100 years. Let us hear for 100 years. You know, why Sharad is used as Samvatsara, for the Samvatsara. In later times, you call it as Varsha, you know, Varsha, and Varsha is used in our regional languages also, Kiyad Varsham, Kiyad Varshani, etc. So, Varsha denotes Samvatsara, but in the Vedic times, in the older Sanskrit, it is always Sharat, used for Samvatsara, for a year, Y-E-A-R, why so? You can have your own research and we'll discuss it sometime later. I have my own logic for that. Maybe I'll give it to you later. I'll give you one clue perhaps, you know. Sharadivai bhuyishtha rogaha. Sharadivai bhuyishtha rogaha. That is a clue for you. Okay? And on that you can build up your premise, your theory of justification why Sharad is used as Samvatsara. Okay. So, Bhava Bharta Sharad Shatam. You be Bharta for 100 autumn seasons. Of whom? Dharini Bhuta Dharinyoho. Of Dharini, the queen's name is Dharini. And Bhuta Dharini, Bhuta Naam, Dharini, Naam, Dhara, Prithivi, Kshama, Vasundara, Vasudha. Okay. So, this earth who bears all the bhutas, not necessarily human beings, all the beings, bhutas, those who are born, okay, those who are born, bhavanti iti bhutani, bhutanam dharini, ataha bhuta dharini nama prithivi, tvam bharta bhava, kasyaha bharta, धारिण्याः भर्ता भूतधारिण्याश्च भर्ता. ओके, यू बी द हस्बैंड ऑफ क्वीन धारिणी एज वेल एज द अर्थ विच बेयर्स एंड सस्टेन्स ऑल द बीइंग्स. दिस इज द लास्ट लाइन. नाउ इन द फर्स्ट लाइन देर आर टू विशेषणस, टू विशेषणस, टू एडजेक्टिव्स. देर इज अ श्लेष, दिस इज अ श्लेषालंकार. देर इज धारिणी भूतधारिण्यो, देर इज अ अनुप्रास ऑल्सो, अलिटरेशन, अलिटरेशन ऑल्सो. सो नाउ द टू विशेषणस अप्लाय बोथ टू धारिणी एज वेल एज भूतधारिणी, इट इज पृथ्वी. हाउ विस इज महासार प्रसवयो, महासार प्रसवयो, प्रसव बर्थ इमर्जेंस, बोथ ऑफ देम गिव बर्थ टू, बोथ ऑफ देम क्वीन धारिणी एज वेल एज अर्थ गिव बर्थ टू व्हाट, महासार, महत् सारम, यस्य सह, महत् सारम येषां तत् महासार. This could mean Dharini has given birth to a son who has more valor, who is very brave. Mahatsaram, like some essence. Sara, Sara is essence, isn't it? Sara, you have the liquid or the essence, the rasa. Sara and rasa, you have just varna viparyaya. It means one and the same. So Sara is the gist, okay? So gist of the great essence. I mean, she has given birth to the most powerful progeny, that is Vasumitra. So mahat saram asya, naturally, because he has gone a 16-year young boy, not old, 16-year young boy, nukti misrud phutlela, you know, just in his puberty age, he has gone to protect the horse. And he has fought against the mlechas on the banks of Sindhu river, which we come to know in the last act. So such a brave son, usko jana hai, right? She has given birth to such a valiant, such a brave child. So mahasara prasava. And how it could be made applicable to the earth? Any guess? Whatever earth produces, it gives the bala to the bhutas, the anna, the dhanya which she produces. So the produce of Mother Earth, mahasara prasava, when you apply it to earth, it is the produce of the Mother Earth which gives great strength to all the bhutas, be it a worm or a human being or a dinosaur. It is all, they are all nourished on the produce of this Mother Earth, right? And therefore, Mahasara Prabhava Yoho. Some commentators, they have this Mahasara Prabhava Yoho made applicable to Agnimitra and Dharini instead of Dharini and Bhuta Dharini. Because this is the son who both of them, you know, they have produced, both Agnimitra and Dharini together have given birth to a great son. But it doesn't look good, you know. Why bring Agnimitra here all of a sudden when there is no reference to him? The reference is to Dharini and Bhuta Dharini, and therefore the Shlesha should go with Dharini and Bhuta Dharini. But I am just giving you the different opinions of the commentators, okay? So Dharini, Bhuta Dharini, so these two are the upameyas and the upamanas, the visheshanas are mahasara prabhavayoho, number one, and sadrisha kshamayoho dvayoho, both of them who are very patiently bearing everything. The very name of Mother Earth is kshma or kshama, because kitne atyachar sahti hai wo, hai na? She bears all these different beings. How much traumatized she becomes because of our ill treatment to her. But she patiently bears. Sometimes only she shakes, there is earthquake. Only sometimes, not frequent. But she patiently tolerates all our misdeeds, all our mischiefs. Therefore is Kshama. And for Dharini also, Parivrajika has very intelligently used this Kshamashilatva for Dharini because it is suggested, it is Agamini, because Malavika will be wedded to Agnimitra and she will have to bear with one more co-wife in the near future. But Dharini is, her heart is magnanimous enough to accommodate even Malavika. She has already accommodated the younger queen Iravati. Similarly, she will accommodate any other new queen which Agnimitra is going to marry hereafter. Okay? So that is the Kshamashilatva of Dharini Suchita. Nowhere it is, you know, distinctly or clearly mentioned by Kalidasa, but it is indicated, it is suggested, because her Kshamashilatva will be put to test once Malavika appears on the stage and once Agnimitra and Malavika are going to get wedded. Okay, so she will have to exercise her guna, her quality of that patient tolerance. Okay, and therefore Kshama Sadrushak Kshamayoho Dvayoho. So both these visheshanas are applicable to Dharini and Bhuta Dharini in toto, and therefore this is a perfect upama. There is a shlesha, so many alankara, just a very small verse, but then beautiful alankaras and beautiful vastu dhvani. When I said dhvani, it is suggested, right? It is gamyate or suchyate or vyajyate. This is nowhere clearly stated. Dhvani, you have to extract the meaning. For that, you have to read between the lines, between the words sometimes, and into the etymological meaning of the word. Kshama, kshma, okay? Now, Dharini also, as the protocol demands, Jayatu Aryaputraha, always the ladies, the queens, will address their husbands as Aryaputra, Aryasya Putraha. Arya would refer to their Shvashura, their father-in-law, Tasya Putraha. So they can't address, you know, by name, not like today's thing, right? So they won't address their husbands by name, and they won't address by any other name, Sunte Hoji, like that. So it is Aryaputra, especially in the dramas, it is Aryaputra. Because Arya is the elderly person who is the Sasura, Shvashura, Shvashura, Sasura. Swagatam Devyai, he will address her as Devi. Swagatam Devyai, Parivrajikam Vilokya, Bhagavati Kriyatam Asana Parigraha. Before offering asana to his queen, he offers asana to Bhagavati. Sarve yathochitam upavishanti bhagavati atrabhavatoho haradatta ganadasayoho parasparam vidnyana sangharsho jataha tadatra bhagavatya prashnika padam adhyasitavyam. Now why they are called for here? So Raja explains that there is a fight between these two over mutual superiority, and therefore I have called you here so that you be the judge, the jury, and examine their skills, and then you decide who is better over the other. There is vidnyana sangharshaha. There is a sangharsha between them as regards to their vidnyana. Now the specific term vidnyana, you know, we have in the Upanishads jnanam vidnyana sahitam. Pure jnana is one thing and vidnyana is the other thing. Vidnyana is vishishtam jnanam. It is like practical knowledge. Vidnyana is practical knowledge, and therefore in the normal vocabulary of the regional languages, we have vidnyana pathashala or vidnyana kala vanijya vidnyana college, you know, like school, mahavidyalaya. Vidnyana is used for science. Why? Because it is practically implemented knowledge. Jnana is pure saiddhantika knowledge, whereas vidnyana is practical knowledge. And Vijnana here is very significant. I mean, I told you that I won't be reading all the prose sentences, but then I am tempted to read every bit of it because, you know, this can take you back to Ganadasa. He says that I have gathered my Vidya from a very good guru, Datta Prayogaschasmi, and I have given performances. It is not that I have only the theoretical knowledge of the dance, but I have performed. So this being a performing art, only theoretical knowledge is not going to help. And therefore the Sangharsha is regarding the Vijnana, okay? Vijnana Sangharsha, huh? And you be the jury. Then Parivrajika says, Alam Upalambena, why are you taunting me? You are the best person to judge, you know, why should I be the judge? And the sentence she uses, you know, you can use it anywhere in the Sanskrit terminology, in your Sarala Sanskrit Sambhashana. Pattane vidyamane api grame ratna pariksha. You have a beautiful gem or a jewel and you want to examine what, how many carat the gold is, or the diamond, you know, something like a diamond, how valuable that diamond is. Do you go to a village for its examination, or you go to a big saraf, big goldsmith shop in a city? In the villages, the poor people stay. Where do they have that acumen? Where do they have that skill of pariksha of good gems, you know? So now here, Malavika, a gem, is going to be tested for her performance, how good or bad she is. And you are there to judge. You are a dhira, lalita type of king. And I am a sannyasini. I am a yativeshadharini. And you are coming to me as a prashnika, as an examiner. Who will be the better judge? You or me? So pattana is you yourself. Pattane vidyamane api grame. She is referring to herself as grame. So very beautiful sentence. When there are more opportunities available elsewhere, and when it is possible to be tested in big places, why do a person go to a small place for getting it tested? He won't, right? So why should you come to me? I mean, this is her vinaya, her humility. She is also, you know, very pandita. She is a pandita. And so as a pandita, she is supposed to know everything. But then she wants to give credit to the king. पत्तने विद्यमाने पि ग्रामे रत्न परीक्षा मा मा एवं पंडित कौशिकी खलु भगवती ओ ही इज ऑल्सो सो दिस इज परस्परम भावयन्तः फॉर सम टाइम इट विल गो ऑन पक्षपातिनौ आवयोः अहम देवी च एंड देन ही गिव्स द रीजन व्हाई शी शुड बी द जज बिकॉज हरदत्त कम्स अंडर किंग ही इज अपॉइंटी ऑफ द किंग एंड गणदास इज अपॉइंटेड बाय द क्वीन सो इफ वी टू आर वेयर टू बी द जजेस I will favor my party, the queen will favor her party, but you are trayastha, you are impartial. Vayam pakshapatino, we too are pakshapatino, we may be, you know, partial and to our own parties, but you are a udasina person. Then the acharyas step in and say, samyagaha devaha, madhyastha bhagavati, gunadoshau naha, parichhettum arhati. She is a madhyastha. She doesn't belong to any party, neither Ganadasa nor Haradatta. So she is the best person. Naha parichettum. Naha gunadoshau parichettum. To divide, to analyze and decide on our gunas and doshas, merits and demerits. There is a Pathabheda here. I leave it to you to choose whichever Pathabheda. I'm very, you know, like... I'm tempted to tell you so many things about the scribal errors and which reading you should adopt for a critical edition. Gunadoshau naha parichhettum arhati, or nau gunadoshataha parichhettum arhati. Nau, we too. Bhagavati parichhettum arhati. She deserves to analyze and decide. We too. On the basis of our merits and demerits, that is one sentence, and she is the best suitable to analyze and decide our merits and demerits. देर इज अ स्लाइट डिफरेंस. नहा गुणदोषौ एंड नौ गुणदोषतः. सो वेदर वी डिजर्व टू बी द डांस मास्टर्स हियर और नॉट, देर इज अ वेरी स्लाइट. डू यू गेट माई पॉइंट और नो? या. सो नौ गुणदोषतः परिच्छेत्तुं, नौ वी टू, ओके, और नहा दैट इज अस्माकं नहा, षष्ठी आवयोः, सो दैट इज षष्ठी. सो दिस इज अ स्मॉल दिस थिंग, यू नो, पाठभेद. यू मे ट्राई टू डिसाइड ऑन दैट. तैन ही प्रस्तूयताम विवादः. राजा सेज ओके, नाउ भगवती इज हियर, शी हैज अग्रीड, सो यू आर ऑल्सो एग्रींग टू दैट, सो ट्राई युअर डिबेट, यू नो, यू कैन स्टार्ट युअर डिबेट. परिव्राजिका स्टेप्स इन. देव प्रयोग प्रधानम ही नाट्यशास्त्र. दिस नाट्यशास्त्र और नृत्यशास्त्र इज अ परफॉर्मिंग आर्ट. वॉट इज द यूज ऑफ हैविंग अ वर्बल डिबेट हियर, यू नो, whether you know ekadasha sangrah, whether you know how many rasas are there, what are the sthayi bhavas and this and that, that I don't want. Prayoga pradhanam hi natyashastram kimatra vagvyavaharena. What is the use of only verbal debate here? Katham va devi manyate. And very innocently she asks, but I must take into consideration what does devi dharini think of it. See, Parivrajika is slowly heading towards bringing Malavika in front of King Agnimitra, because she is already a party to the conspiracy played by Gautama, right? The Vidushaka. And therefore, but then she should plead that she should, you know, pretend at least that she is very innocent in all that. Kathamba Devi Manyate, how does Devi feel? What is your opinion, Queen? Yadi mam prichasi eta yoho vivada evam na me rochate. If you ask me, I don't like the idea of they two, you know, debating at all, because she tries to like mule kuthara ghat. I don't like this at all. I don't entertain this at all. Ganadasa takes it as, you know, perhaps Devi is apprehensive of his defeat, and therefore he says, न माम समान विद्यातः परिभवनीयम अवगंतुम अर्हसि. डोंट ट्रीट मी, यू नो, डोंट थिंक दैट आई एम लिटिल लोअर दैन द अदर फेलो, द हरदत्त. बोथ ऑफ अस हैव इक्वल ट्रेनिंग, समान विद्या और अभिनय विद्या, बट आई एम नो वे एनी लेसर दैन हरदत्त. सो डोंट थिंक दैट आई विल लूज इन दैट. ही इज कॉन्फिडेंट ऑफ हिज ओन सेल्फ एंड ही फील्स दैट देवी इज ट्राइंग टू अवॉइड दैट, because she is apprehensive of his defeat. So from his side he has to state it. Vidushaka, now, you know, like aag mein tel dalna, that is his work. He is like kali cha narad. In Marathi we say kali cha narad. Aur thoda badhayenge, aur thoda jhagda badhayenge na. So he says, bhavati pashyamaha urabhra sampatam. Two rams are fighting here, you know. Two rams. Urabhra is a ram. He goat, very valiant he goat. Ram. Urabhra sampatam pashyamaha. Let us see the two rams fight. There is another pathabed, and that I want you to certainly look forward, look upon. It is udarambhara sampatam or udarambhara samvadam. Udarambhara samvada is another pathabed for that. Udarambhara or kukshimbhara is, you know, like petu, one who is, you know, getting something or doing something just to fill his stomach. Some livelihood he is doing just to fill the stomach, just to get some money to eat. Udarambhara samvada. Let us hear the samvada, the dialogue, the conversation of these two who are here only to fill their bellies, you know, they don't know anything. I mean, this is instigating them. Both of them he wants to instigate. So whether udarambhara samvada is a good option or urabhra sampatam is good option, you have to decide. I will tell you next time. Pabhavati pashyamaha urabhra sampatam kim mudha vetana danena. Why should we give them vetana, you know? Vetana is the remuneration, the honorarium, the salary, so to say. It is, you know, interestingly derived from we is to go. So one who goes with that, I mean one who lives with that, unless he gets that, he can't live. That is one way of interpreting it. And some people derive it from vartana, livelihood. So what is helpful for livelihood is vetana, okay? Kim mudha vetana danena? Why pay them unnecessarily? Let us enjoy their fight, you know, on this. Nanu kalaha priyosi. You indeed take pleasure in the fights, Devi is saying. Ma evam. Anyonya kalahitayoho mattahastinoho ekatarasmin anirjite kutaha upashamaha. When there are two elephants, now first he says two rams. Now here he says two hastinoho, mattahastinoho. They are intoxicated elephant. They are up to fight. One of them should be defeated, then only the fight will end. You can't end it abruptly like that, you know. Let them fight. Let one get defeated, then we'll see. Then Raja wants to play his innocent part, you know. He says, oh, now you have already seen, no, their performances in Sangeeta Shala. Oh, Bhagavati, Kaushiki. Nanu Swanga Saushtava Abhinayam Ubhayoho Drishtavati. You have already seen their Swanga Saushtava. Okay? Swanga Saushtava, Bharata has so many things to tell about that in the Natya Shastra. He says, you know, like, Nahi Saushtava Heenangaha Shobhate Natya Nritya Yoho. For the dance and for the drama, the characters which you choose have to be Sva Anga Saushtava, all their limbs in proper shape and proportionate. Just tell me, if somebody is playing the role of Ravana and he is like a single pasli person, how would you take it? Right? So Swanga, Sva Anga Saushtava, fitting those characters, okay? He gives you so many other things, and the end is Natyam Nrityam Cha Sarvam Hi Saushtave Sampratishthitam. Be it Natya or be it Nritya, Saushtave Sampratishthitam. Sushthu Shobhanani Angani Yasya. So Swanga Saushtavam. So you have already seen, no, Ganadas and Haradatta, O Bhagavati. So now you decide on that. Performing, you said Prayoga Pradhanam Natyam. You have already seen their Natya sometime back. So do it now. Then she says, yes, I have seen it. Tadidani matakparam kim abhyam pratyakhyapayitavyam? Pratyayayitavyam? Very innocent, you know, king. Very, very innocent. He says, if you have already seen their performances in Sangeeta Shala, what else they have to prove now? Pratyayayitavyam, prayojaka. And then Nijanta, potential passive participle. Okay. What else they need to prove themselves now? You have already seen their Swanga Saushtava. Tadeva Vaktu Kamasmi. That alone I want to say. And there comes a very, very beautiful verse by Kavikula Guru Kalidasa. And this is so true even today. Underline it as the universal definition of an ideal teacher. This is a universal definition of an ideal teacher. What she says, the gist I'll tell you first, then we'll read the verse. There are some people, you know, some teachers, which you also, we come across in our life. We are eternally students. Even now, I am a student. So we come across so many people from whom we get some jnana kana, okay? We gather some tits and bits of knowledge. We observe that some people are there who are very good. They are extremely intelligent, extremely knowledgeable. They have, you know, they are the storehouse of knowledge. But when it comes to imparting that knowledge, they lack it. Sometimes there is no communication skill. Sometimes there is no eye contact. Sometimes there is no interaction. Sometimes there is no curiosity aroused of the students. There are so many ways to make a session interesting, interactive, and you know. But then there are some people who have, you know, so much of knowledge, but it rests with them. There are, on the other hand, some people, whatever little they know, they easily communicate with you. They become one with you. They become friendly with you, and they can communicate and impart and transfer that knowledge very, very efficiently, very skillfully. If at all the person who is good at transferring the knowledge, if at all he also has the storehouse of knowledge, how wonderful it would be. That means, what do you conclude? That an ideal teacher should have knowledge and should also have the skill of communication and imparting, transferring that knowledge to his shishyas. If that knowledge rests with him and dies with him, what is the use? So, ideal teacher should be one. Yasya ubhayam sa sadhu shikshakanam dhuri pratishtha paitavya eva. One who has both. Both. What are the both things? These are spoken in the first two lines. Shlishta kriya kasya chid atma samstha. Kriya. Whatever his action, knowledge impartation, his action, that is his duty. For a teacher, knowledge transfer is his duty. For that he is paid. Whether he is paid or not, that is his duty. Dissemination of knowledge we talk of. Dissemination. Distribution of knowledge. Whatever you know, you should impart it to others. But a person doesn't have the skill. His kriya is shlishta. It is clinging to him. Shlesha. What is shlesha? Two things coming close together. Ashlesha, embrace. So his vidya embraces him. It stays with him. Shlishta kriya kasya chit atma samstha. In him only. Sankranti ranyasya vishesha yukta. In some other, sankranti, the transference, imparting, is vishesha, is very much, you know, underlined, it is emphasized. It is a special characteristic of that person. Yasya ubhayam sadhu, the person in whom both these are good, in good proportion, that means the person is knowledgeable as well as he has a good skill of communication, and he can transfer that knowledge, transmit that knowledge to his shishyas. Such a teacher, dhuri pratishtha payitavya eva, he should be placed at the head of the entire community of the teaching fraternity. Okay, community of teachers. So who is the best teacher? One who has knowledge and one who can transfer that knowledge. One who can create the shishyas who are, if not equal to him, if not superior to him, at least equal to him. Because that is the duty of a good teacher, to create his replicas, to create his dummies. Because when he passes away, his replicas would take it over again, and they start doing, running the gurukulas, running, coming into the teaching fraternity and teaching in the similar manner. An ideal teacher is he who can produce his dummies, multiple dummies, multiple students. After listening to them, you remember the guru. Oh, he speaks like his guru. He speaks like his teacher, right? So, what I mean to say is, ideal teacher is he who has knowledge as well as the skill of transferring that knowledge. Both things are essential for a good teacher. Now, what Parivrajika is indicating at? I have seen both these teachers' performances. Because they are Datta Prayoga, I have seen them. But how skilled they are in the transference of their knowledge, that I want to test. Whether whatever they have learned, they have ably communicated it to their students, that I want to see. And therefore, I don't want to decide anything by seeing their performances, I want their students' performances, and I would judge that, and then on the basis of that, I would judge the teacher. She is slowly coming to the fructification of the plan of Vidushaka. If the both the teachers agree, yes, we agree to this, that our students would perform, and you can judge on the basis of our students, then Malavika will be brought in front of King Agnimitra, right? That is what it is heading towards, okay? And therefore she says, Shlishta Kriya. Now again I want you to work on this, okay? There is so much of homework today. There is a Pathabheda as Shishta, not Shlishta. So whether you prefer Shishta or Shlishta, you have to tell me in the group. Shrikant will get back to me with your answers. And if so, if you are preferring the Pathabheda Shlishta, Kale has taken Shishta. Others have taken Shlishta. Okay, so which Pathabheda you prefer and why? Justify that. Shlishta or Shishta. Shishta is good. Shishta Sammata. Right? Shishta is good. Accepted by all. Okay? Shishta Kriya Kasyachid Atma Samstha. So very beautiful Arthantaranyasa here. What is Arthantaranyasa Alankara? Is when you give from a particular Samanya sentence, it becomes Arthantaranyasa. Samanyena Visheshasya, Visheshenava Samanyasya. Yada Arthanirdharanam Kriyate Tada Arthantaranyasa Alankara. And wherever there occurs Arthantaranyasa, mark it as a Vastudvani. This is a Vastudvani. The fact that this is the definition of an ideal teacher is suggested. Nowhere Kalidasa says, now let me give you a definition of an ideal teacher. Right? But the ideal teacher's definition gets suggested through this verse. Okay? So very beautiful verse. So Shrutamaryabhyam Bhagavatya Vachanam. Now Vidushaka wants to sum it up by saying, did you both hear what Bhagavati Kaushiki said? Esha Pinditarthaha, this is the gist of that. Upadesha Darshanena Nirnayaha Iti. How the Nirnaya will come? How she will decide who is superior and who is inferior? Upadesha Darshanena. Upadesha, your transference of knowledge. You show that. That means you perform through your students, and that will decide who is superior, who is inferior. Param Uchitam Naha. Param Abhimatam Naha. There is a Pathabheda. Param Ruchitam Naha. Ruchitam. Not good, right? Ruchitam. Param Uchitam Naha. Yes, it is proper for us. Abhimatam Naha. We agree to that. Then Ganadasa said, Devi, evam sthitam, now this has come to this state that I have to present through my shishya, through my disciple, Malavika. Devi is still apprehensive because Malavika, she has got recently assigned to Ganadasa, right? Iravati has been learning with Haradatta for so many days. Then she is, you know, fearing of the loss of Ganadasa in the fight. Yadha punar mandamedha Shishya upadesham malinayati tada acharyasya doshahanu. Mandamedha shishya. If a dull-witted student malinayati acharyasya upadesham. She doesn't justify, doesn't do justice to the upadesha of the acharya, may be good. But the shishya is not good. Is it the dosha of the acharya? I don't want you to lose just because that Shishya, Malavika, is Mandamedha. Mandamedha Shishya. There is another Pathabheda. There are so many Pathabhedas. Very interesting this is. It is not Mandamedha Shishya. Mandamedha Saha. Mandamedha Saha Acharyasya Shishya. If the Acharya itself is, you know, Mandamedhas, and the Shishya cannot perform, then also Acharya will lose. Both ways Acharya will lose. One thing is the Acharya himself is not capable enough. Other thing is the shishya is not capable enough to grasp it. Do you feel then the acharya is to be blamed for that? Tasya doshahanu or tasya doshahana? It is not his dosha. It is an exclamation. It is a question. Nu or na? Again, Pathabheda. It is na or no. Then the Raja wants to interfere and says, intervening, he says, E Devi, evam apadyate, apathyate, that is another thing, evam upapadyate, that is also Pathabheda. And again a beautiful Arthantaranyasa. Who says that the alankaras can occur only in the verses, only in the shlokas? Alankaras can occur in apparently, seemingly prose sentences. That is the khasiyat of Kalidasa. In a prose sentence, in a dialogue, you know, he brings in beautiful alankaras. Again, a beautiful alankara of Arthantaranyasa. Vinetuhu adravya parigraha api buddhilaghavam prakashayati. Vinetuhu buddhilaghavam prakashayati. Kim prakashayati? Adravya parigraha. Dravya, na dravyam adravyam. That which is not a substance. Dravya is a substance. Adravya, non-substantial. That which doesn't have substance, okay? Dravya is a substance. So, adravya parigraha. Parigraha, acceptance. Acceptance of a person having no substance, that is manda buddhi shishya, accepting such a shishya, it throws light on the buddhi laghava, that is buddhihinata, that is the lack of intelligence of vinetuhu. Vinetu, the teacher. Vinetu visheshena nayati shishyam saha. Vinetru or vineta, that is a teacher, okay? Vinaya, by the way, vinaya is not just humility. Vidya vinayena shobhate, we say. Vidya vinayena shobhate. It is not just humility. Vinaya also means training, education. Okay? And therefore, in that sense, vinetru, the educator, the teacher, the acharya. So, accepting a mandabuddhi shishya, mandabuddhi person as a shishya, reflects on the lack of intelligence of the good teacher. That means a good teacher to create students of his caliber should accept people who are good, whom he should accept as the shishya, you know. So, buddhi laghavam and buddhi gauravam, these are the two words used, like, you know, in this alternatively. So, buddhi laghavam prakashayati, if I want heritage or my lineage to be continued even after me, I should group, pick and choose some students and groom them so that they would take my tradition ahead. Every gurukula, every guru chooses such a student. Just see how Satyakama Jabala of Haridrumata Gautama, Gautama Haridrumata accepted Satyakama Jabala as a student. Later on, he became an Antevasi and he started running that Gurukula. Right? Utathya, he started running the Gurukula of his teacher. We see so many examples like this. The teacher and the Shishya, and Shishya becomes the teacher, then his Shishya, he becomes the teacher. This is how the Guru Parampara, we say, Vande Guru Paramparam. Right? So, you have to pick and choose a good person, an intelligent person, a receptive person for your Shishya. If you fail in that, you are going to fail in all grounds. Okay? So, it is up to the teacher to accept a person as his Shishya. And so, now Raja is pointing out, if Ganadasa has accepted a Manda Buddhi Shishya, that is his fault. If the Shishya cannot perform, that is not the dosha of the Shishya, that is the dosha of the Guru. Okay? दिस विल प्रूव ऑन द अदर हैंड वेदर मालविका इज मंदबुद्धि और नॉट. वी आर हेडिंग टूवर्ड्स द लाइव परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ मालविका ऑन द स्टेज. वी आर हेडिंग टूवर्ड्स दैट एंड दिस इज अ बैकग्राउंड क्रिएटेड थ्रू टूवर्ड्स दैट. ओके. अद्रव्य परिग्रहः अपि विनेतुः बुद्धिलाघवं प्रदर्शयति स्वगतम. नाउ क्वीन हैज स्टार्टेड यू नो टू एंड दिस कॉन्फ्लिक्ट राइट फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग लाइक मूले कुठारा गाता कथम इदानीं व्हाट डू आई डू व्हाट डू आई डू. शी इज सो डेस्परेट एंड देन शी सेज यू नो वेरी टॉन्टिंगली अलम आर्यपुत्र शी सेज इट टू गणदास अलम आर्यपुत्रस्य उत्साह कारणं मनोरथं पूरयित्वा. शी नोज वाई ऑल दिस इज हैपनिंग. दिस इज हैपनिंग फॉर मालविका टू बी ब्रॉट ऑन द स्टेज. शी नोज इट फॉर सर्टन एंड देयर फॉर शी सेज टू गणदास इनफ ऑफ दिस यू नो दिस इज गोइंग टू जस्ट सैशिएट माई हजबेंड्स डिजायर. आर्यपुत्रस्य उत्साह कारणं मनोरथम हिज विश दैट इज टू सी माल. ही हैज सीन मालविका ओनली इन अ पोर्ट्रेट राइट ओनली इन अ पोर्ट्रेट. नाउ ही वॉन्ट्स टू सी हर इन पर्सन. इफ दिस इज गोइंग टू हैपन एंड मालविका इज ब्रॉट ऑन द स्टेज एज द शिष्योपदेश देन इट इज हिज उत्साह कारण मनोरथ पूर्ण दैट एंड दैट शी वॉन्ट्स टू अवॉइड. गणदासं विलोक्य विरम निरर्थकात् आरंभात् दैट इज हर ऑर्डर नाउ. विरम स्टॉप. आई डोंट वॉन्ट दिस फसाद. ये झगड़ा फसाद चाहिए ही नहीं मुझे. विरम दैट कम्स एज एन ऑर्डर. शुड लेट अस सी इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वेदर गणदास एंड द होल थिंग यू नो दिस इज लाइक वेदर इट विल हैपन और नॉट हैपन. द गुड ड्रामेटिस्ट ऑलवेज यू नो stretches your curiosity. He makes you anxious enough. Oh, whether Malavika would come or no. This, that. So we get oscillated between, you know, whether this will happen or not happen. That is the skill of a true dramatist. Is it not? So let us see and wait in the next lecture whether Malavika's darshana is there for Agnimitra and all of us or no. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरिः ओम. सी यू नेक्स्ट संडे विथ दैट क्यूरियोसिटी दैट एंग्जाइटी. And you can read a further portion, but I will be reading it anyhow. First act, at least, let me read fully. So till then, Hari Om.